How do you approach a mix, getting the mix? Now, on the general session, we did, you know, of course, we're in Ocean Way, a really nice studio, but you were still dialing in the drums, you were dialing in the mix, and you build it like you're building a building, building a foundation. Just talk about the practical way that a sound engineer needs to deal with building this mix every week.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what my perspective is on that is that I come from the studio world. So I spent years in the studio mixing records. And so with that in mind, knowing what I want to hear on how a record sounds. So whenever I'm out on the road with Don, I've had the pleasure of mixing a couple of his records as well. I'm always trying really hard to make it sound like a record, and so that's my point of reference. And if I walk away from that evening and it just doesn't sound like what I wanted, I usually walk away a little disappointed. But so the concept that I do again is making it sound like a record. The first thing you have to do is know what you want to accomplish when you're mixing a song, you know, or when you're mixing the music. Know what things are foundational, where things need to sit in the mix, what you need to hear and not hear, what invokes emotion, what best translates in the song. So when I asked the question earlier, are you a musician? Whether you said yes or no, at this point, if you're an audio engineer, then you need to answer yes. And the first thing that you've got to do is listen really hard. So I have the advantage of having listened to songs from the inside out, one instrument at a time, and analyzing each instrument. But if you sit down and listen to the radio or to iTunes or whatever and get songs that you like the way they sound or worship songs that are in the genre that your church is doing, listen. Understand, where does the bass drum sit in relation to the snare drum? Where is the lead vocal next to that? Where are the guitars? You know, and you think about things like panning left and right, EQ, all of those things. Another important thing is to make sure that instruments aren't getting in each other's way, which becomes that shaping thing. When I talked about EQ earlier, we use the EQ to shape things. And, you know, you can go online and find these charts of where instruments sit in the frequency spectrum. And you can look, okay, electric guitars are kind of like a high mid instrument. So they're going to pop out there. So you might, in the context of a mix, you might want to shave off some of the highs and some of the lows so that leaves room for like the cymbals or the vocals or the bass drum and the bass guitar, and let the guitars sit in that place so that the other instruments can sit in their places and the vocals. And so you really, you know, when I'm building a mix, I start with the foundational things, which is the low frequencies, the bass drum and the bass guitar, build the drum mix around that. And then I'll move on usually to the guitars after that and just placing them, getting them to sound right. And then I'll go to the keyboards and then I'll throw the vocals on top. And all of that, again, bearing in mind that music is an artistic expression and it also is something that evokes emotions in people. So the best, I believe that God created our emotions and he gave us this place in our psyche where he can touch us emotionally and we can respond to him in that. And a lot of times he uses music to do that. So as an audio engineer, it's one thing to understand and know all the technical stuff, but you have to get to the point where you appreciate and love the art part of it too and the emotional part of it. And that's, you know, I will sit back at the board sometimes and I almost get as emotional about a sonic experience as I do about a lyric experience or a musical experience. So I'm always striving for that sonic excellence and getting something that sounds really good. And so hopefully the audience is hearing it too, you know. That's my heart.